Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today we will be taking a look at the Huawei Mate 20X. It comes at a beautiful 7.2 inches with an OLED screen, a triple camera setup with a 40-megapixel camera, a 20-megapixel camera, and an 8-megapixel camera with super fast Face ID, even faster than the actual iPhone XS, and a cool Touch ID sensor. It comes with a 7-nanometer chip, the blue color here, and just some amazing cooling, amazing battery life, and I'd like to talk about all of this in this video. Now, you've seen all of the videos this week that I've posted about the Huawei. I hope you enjoyed all of those, and today I'm just going to take all of that, put it into one video, and just talk about the whole experience. Let's start off with daily usage. So daily usage is pretty incredible. So for daily usage, we're gonna take a look at performance and battery life. So performance is actually good. I would say good because sometimes when I open an app, it just takes some time to load, but that's okay, I guess. Then when swiping out, it seems a little bit buggy because I've set the actual like swipey thing instead of the buttons on the bottom. So sometimes just bugs out when you go into this menu and it just keeps scrolling in there. So it doesn't happen all the time, but that's something to mention, I guess. It comes with great speakers actually, but I heard better. I think the iPhone speakers are way better than these, even though that these are stereo, but there's one on top here and one here, which get covered by your hands easily, and therefore the audio is actually coming from I don't know where. Are you supposed to like, just that's something that I don't really like. It comes with USB-C charging, fast charging, which is really great. A headphone jack for those people who still use headphone jacks, like not me anyway. But yeah, so performance is good, some issues. Battery life is incredible. So I run it about a week with like really like daily usage. That's pretty incredible. So right now I'm at 30% and I am having still about 10 hours of battery life left, which is pretty incredible. Watching videos on a big screen is amazing, watching movies and things, pretty incredible. I talked about the camera, photos, video, all of that on this phone. Now, the camera is amazing. I'm just gonna say that it's amazing. Video mode, like if you're shooting, like vlogging with this phone, is great. When you're taking pictures, it's like realistic. It's like less vivid than on the iPhone. So you can get the raw format, so you can go edit those pictures. So that's maybe why. But otherwise, like macro, like panorama, time lapse, slow motion, they're good. Like great. Honestly, if you're looking for a phone around the $600 or so, then I would recommend this phone. Even though that I was looking last time, this phone is actually from China. So I did not really see it in Europe much, so I don't know if you can really go get it, but you can go get it in China. It's great. It's a great phone. I think you can only get the P30 or Mate 30, or I have no clue. But this phone at 7.2 inches with triple camera setup is the dream setup, actually. Battery life, performance, everything insane. I am really happy that I got this phone and I'm reconsidering using my iPhone now, which is for the first time in a long time. Even though I miss like the FaceTime and like iMessage and stuff like that, I carry two phones now. Yay me, I guess. Anyway, it has a cool grip. I love the midnight blue color. You can get it in Phantom Silver, which is purple, by the way. Anyway, would I recommend this phone? Totally, totally. If you want a big phone, not that expensive, only available in China, then this is your phone to go with. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe for more videos like this and some Apple news, which is I love doing. Anyway, take care and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.